Excel In-Depth Chapter 30, Draw Borders. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, the Draw Borders tools are back in Excel 2010. They're here in this drop-down on the Home tab, although I moved the drop-down up to the Quick Access toolbar so it'll fit in our screen. What I'm really interested in here are these five new tools. They're not new. They were here in Excel 2003 and then they went away. So we can choose a line style and also a line color. Now choosing either one of these automatically puts me in draw border mode. You can see the dots are appearing and I have the pencil. Now we want to check, there's two different modes, draw border and draw border grid. When we're in draw border, we can draw single borders just by clicking the border. So if I wanted to draw in a few borders, I could do that. If I would draw a range, I'm going to draw a box around the entire range that I select. I can also come in here, let's change to a different line color, choose blue, and do draw border grid. Now draw border grid is a great way to say, hey, I want the grid to appear from here to here, so it fills in the grid the whole time. Now there's lots of different settings in the border drop-down, but I hardly ever find what I want here. I find that most of the time I'm heading out to more borders where I can actually achieve all the things we have been able to do in the dialog box. However, with these new tools, pretty clever that you can use either erase, draw grid, or draw borders, and probably get away with what you want to do without ever going out to the format size. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.